Hey guys, this is Shishiri for Undoing a Vlog. It's 2:56. It's July. No, January 2nd. The New Year's messed up my mind. But, I was just, looking online and, I ran into this story. Now, I'm not gonna say the YouTuber's name because I want no one to see this video. But I'm going to talk about the Aki Gohara Forest, which is one of the four forests around Mount Fuji in Japan. And this one is nicknamed the Suicide Forest. As since the 1960s or so, people have chosen this place because of its silence, because of its easiness to get lost, to commit suicide. And in the past, like the far, far past, they would abandon the sickly and the elderly in this forest to die. Now, this is a very sacred place, and Japanese people do not like going there. The only people that go in there that are Japanese are a couple of half-Japanese YouTubers, or people that just live not in this area, in this part of Japan. But I am sickened by what this person did in the video, because his video not only insulted the spirits of Aki Gohara, he disrespected the country of Japan, and he disrespected the dead and the mentally ill. Now, as you know, I'm a channel that's very activist on mental health matters. I have complex post-traumatic stress disorder. I have depression. I have shit like that. I can understand where these people are coming from, especially with the Japanese culture of work, 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 no life, work, 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 work. Suicide happens. There's actually a word for the amount of death and the way people die due to the amount of work they do. Now, to have this YouTuber, who I will never name, and I will not link his video, I am not watching his video, because I am not disrespecting the dead. But all I have to say about this matter really is that if you want to do something to get, like, views, do a challenge, do whatever, don't use other people to do it. Like, I don't like prank channels because of that, because they're kind of, a lot of them are kind of, like, doing really bad things and hurting people. And this is exactly what this guy did. He hurt people. And he insulted a nation. And he insulted the forest. And that forest needs to be respected. Because the Japanese are not trying to hide this forest. They want to stop the suicides as well. They put up billboards saying how much your life is worth. And people actually comb through, like, there are kind of rangers, like park rangers, that comb through this forest daily looking for people, finding people who are intense, who are on the verge of deciding whether they're going to commit suicide, and talk to them and get them possibly out of that forest in a way. Also, in legend, it is a forest said to be haunted by a ghost that clings to your back. And it's just a very silent forest, like eerily silent. It also has a lot of roots and a lot of little caves and a lot of dangerous terrain. So it's a very deadly forest. And not just because of its nickname. Now, this YouTuber who started doing this video, I don't know what kind of person can do this, because I don't think I could do this. I would cry. I would mourn. I don't care. I don't care if I don't know who this person is. I may not even speak their language. If I saw someone like he saw someone, I mean they saw someone, I would not film it. I would cut off the camera, or if I did film it, it'd be by accident of me dropping my camcorder and then somehow ending up still in the shot. And I would definitely not post it online. I'm hoping YouTube takes this video down, because this is just horrible content and it should not be on YouTube. It's exploiting the dead. Like, I don't know how someone can record someone who's died from suicide. Like, that boggles my mind. Because I'm a YouTuber. I'm not a big one. I know I'm not a big one. But I love Japan, and I've always been interested in Japan. And trust me, I've done that curiosity of being like, oh, Akihabara, the suicide forest, I want to learn about it. I learned about it more academically. I watch documentaries, and I watch horror films, and whatever the fuck else they make off that forest. I researched it. I did research on the forest. I did research about what happens there, what they're doing to prevent what's happening there. And to have someone record someone who hung themselves and uploaded it. You don't do that. I don't care. I don't care what people think about victims of suicide, of the bodies of the dead of suicide victims, whether they think they're shameful, whether they think they took the easy way out, whether they think whatever. That is still a dead person. That is someone who died. Someone whose loved ones are missing them. And if you cannot respect the dead, you have no place in humanity in my mind. And to go on to the mental health aspect of this, I'm going to explain this in great detail. I've dealt with suicidal thoughts myself. My own brother dealt with suicidal thoughts and tried to commit suicide. I have friends who tried to commit suicide. And I've talked to people who have committed suicide. And do I think these people took the easy way out? No. They were tortured. To feel suicidal is to be tortured 24/7 by your own brain. And to have someone disrespect you after you're dead. You can't do that. You just can't. That person dealt with enough bullshit in their life. They don't need to have some wannabe white guy YouTuber who's like, oh, the scary Akihabara forest, and go in and videotape their dead body. I delete that footage, to be honest. If I had accidentally recorded the dead body, I'd delete it. It'd be gone. The only length of time I'd probably keep it would be to maybe serve as a guide for police so they can find the body and put it to rest. This makes no sense, and no argument this person can make what he did right. Because it's real. It is, like, that's insulting. And Japan is a very, like, I want to teach in Japan. I wanted to be an English teacher for so many years. I wanted to teach English in there. I want to learn about their culture. I still learn about their culture every day. I'm learning Japanese slowly but surely. I love Japan, and I deal with mental health, and I'm surrounded by mental health issues, people with mental health issues, people who have these thoughts, people who do these actions. I've had someone think and almost try to commit suicide in my own bathroom, in my own apartment. Is if I ever saw that person and it was hanging lifeless, I don't know what I would do. You have to be some sort of sociopath or psychopath to be able to film that and put it on YouTube. And from what I've seen, they wore disrespectful clothing. Like, I mean to say this to some mean, like, maybe that's all he packed, or they packed, but if you're planning to go to Akikohara, you could at very least wear black, wear all black, maybe have a little bit of brick color on you just in case you got lost, but wear black. Don't wear anything with logos, or at least not visible logos. Cause that's a place where people go to die. It's a horrible place. Place where this become this hotbed for where people go to die, but I am so upset. What would ever disrespect a death like that? Do they even understand? That's why I'm on YouTube. That's why I'm an advocate for mental health. That's why I'm showing you the real me, the real person. That's why I have to put the high heels down, because I'm not hiding anything. These people that are hungry for views and do all this horrible stuff, I don't even know the YouTubers. But I'm so sad. I'm brokenhearted at how disrespectful this person has been. Now, you may think, oh, you're just a random white girl who lives in Canada. You can't say anything. But as a YouTube community, I believe we have to say things. And I don't want this person ever doing a video again. Or uploading it. I want their account taken away. I want that video down at the very least. At least let that person's body rest in peace. Because they didn't live in any peace. The greatest disrespect you can do to anyone with mental health. And as a YouTuber with mental health issues, who's dealing with mental health issues, who is an advocate for mental health issues, who is going to be talking to you many times about mental health issues, I am insulted. I am ashamed to share with this platform as someone who would film that. Would film this kind of thing. And I'm not doing this for clickbait. I really am not. I just needed to film and take out my thoughts on this. And I just want to put out these facts. These reality, which is that you should never disrupt the dead, especially someone who's committed suicide. And number two, you really, 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 really shouldn't go to Akihabara. Don't go there. And if you do go there, be respectful to what's there. Be respectful to that place. Akikohara is meant to be respected. And should be respected. And I hope that this YouTuber, with all the backlash I've been seeing, he's getting, understand that it's not okay. Not okay to do that. It really isn't. Like, don't go to Akihabara. Leave Akihabara alone. It's a place of death and of sadness. And if you're not going there to pay respect or to help and look for people who could still be alive, camping out there to something that they want to die, you should not visit that forest. Just don't. If you want to help, if you want to look for people, if you want to help find people, if you want to help find those people who are sitting in a tent, want to get their tent, please, go to that place, look for people, look for people in your own area where common places of suicide happen, go all over the world, and film suicide victims, dead bodies, to film suicide. You've already heard. The person's already been hurt enough. I'm gonna end this before I get really emotional, but just respect Akihabara in this video and however it travels. I hope he gets his payback for putting that up. I really do. And I just needed to talk about how, and to inform you guys about Akihabara in Japan, and to let you know that if you're someone who's contemplating suicide and you've seen this video and been like, oh, I won't even matter in death, that isn't true. People matter in death as they do in life. And as a person, I mourn everyone. Like, I don't have to know you. I will mourn you. If I hear someone die, I do feel bad. Like, if I know you, if spoken to you on the internet or not, or wherever I spoke to you, you die, I will feel bad. That's just the person I am. I'm just one YouTuber with not many subscribers who's just trying to make the world a better place. I hope 2018 will start a little bit better than this, but that's apparently it's bringing a topic to light that needs to be talked about. If you have any suicidal thoughts, please go get help. Please. There's even one person in your life who you trust. Go to them. Tell them how you feel. And if you can't, dial emergency services hotline that you can in your nation. Whether it's 911, 111, 888, I don't know. I don't know the other ones. But just do it. Because your life may mean something to someone. So, I don't know how to end this video other than I pray for the souls that died in Akikohara and all the other souls that died in Akikohara, and I hope they are able to rest in peace because they deserve peace the very least. So I'm just gonna end this on a moment of silence for them. I hope you guys and my YouTube, my community, feel the same way as me. And that soul that was lost to us, I hope that the life for you on the other side is kind and warm. And I hope the man who ruined and disrespected your thoughts in your death will be taken care of. And however it needs to be. Thank you so much. Cool. For watching us, and God, or Buddha, or anything you believe in, whatever you believe in, but the soul died suicide all across the world, not just in Okinawa, across the entire world. They will all be missed.